Welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am J.P. Dimri, retired professor of Russian from Center of Russian Studies, English and Foreign Languages, University, Hyderabad, Indian Grammatical Linguistics, Pan-Indian Linguistics. In the previous module, we have discussed the division of verbs into 10 major classes, vikarana of these classes, system of tenses and moods, classification of lakaras into sarvadhatuka and ardhatuka, three types of sentences, namely kartrivachya, karmavachya and bhavavachya. In this module, we shall describe the 10 lakaras. As was stated, that the Sanskrit verbal system has three constructions, kartrivachya, karmavachya and bhavavachya. But it has only two voices, parasmayapada, active, and atmanepada, middle. The passive and impersonal constructions are formed by adding the atmanepada suffixes after a verbal root and the passive formation suffix yak. Conjugational suffixes are denoted by the pratyahara ting. Ting pratyahara includes all the conjugational endings of Sanskrit. Pani has also used ting for defining the word as was described before, supti gantam padam. There are three persons and three numbers, so each of the voices contains 9 conjugational suffixes. These ting suffixes are as follows. Active conjugational suffixes, tip tas ji, sip thas tho, mip was mas. Active and middle conjugational suffixes, to atam jho, thas atam dham, it vahi mai. Note that within the ting pratyahara, another pratyahara tang can be formed with the help of to third person singular suffix and the final ga of the first person plural suffix mahi. The pratyahara tang includes all the middle conjugational endings and they are called atmanepada suffixes, and the suffixes beginning with tip to mas first person plural are called parasmayapada suffixes. The atmanepada suffixes are used in the following cases. Andatagit atmanepadam 1312. The sutra states that the atmanepada suffixes are used after a verbal root which in dhatu patha is marked by anudatta accent or no as an indicator. For example, as to sit, aste, he, she, sits. Second, two, bhavakarmanoh 1313. The sutra states that atmanepada suffixes are introduced after a verbal root when bhava, impersonal action, or karman, passive action, is to be expressed. For example, bhava, bhava, as plus yak plus te, asyate, action of sitting down takes place. Karman, kri plus yak plus te, kriyate, kriyate kataha, the mat is being made. Swartayitah kartravipraye kriyapade 1372. The sutra states that the atmanepada suffixes are introduced after a root which has a vowel with swarita, circumflex accent, or yo as an indicator, when the result of the action goes to the agent. For example, yajate performs a sacrifice for himself, but yajati performs a sacrifice for someone else. The parasmayapada suffixes are introduced with the remaining roots in the active constructions. Sheshat kartari parasmayapadam 1378. The sutra states that after the remaining verbal roots, when the agent is to be denoted, parasmayapada suffixes are used. Such verbal roots are listed in the dhatu patha, either with the udatta accent as an indicator or by the absence of the marker ngo or yo. If no reciprocal action is denoted, in other words, where particular rules have not been formulated, parasmayapada suffixes are introduced. There are ubhayapadi roots to which both atmanepada and parasmayapada suffixes can be added. For example, pach to cook, pachati, no, pach to cook, pachate also pachati. kri kurute also karoti. So the dhatus can be atmepadi, parasmepadi and ubhayapadi. Let us now analyze the sutras which assign ting suffixes, suffixes number and person to a dhatu in the process of derivation of a finite verb form. The first step in the derivation of a finite verb form is to add a lakara to the dhatu. The selection of a dhatu depends upon the activity the speaker wants to convey. Further, the selection of a lakara depends upon the time to be expressed and the attitude of the speaker towards the activity. Sometimes particular words in the sentence also influence the use of the particular lakara. The second step in the derivation is to replace a lakara by 18 ting suffixes. The Sutra Lasya 3477 states that in the place of law lakaras, this is a governing rule and its jurisdiction spreads up to the end of the Pada 4, that is to up to the Sutra Chandasyubhayatha 341117. After this rule applies the Sutra Tiptas Ji Siptas Tha Mip Was Mas Tha Atam Jha Thas Atam Dham It By Mind 3478. This sutra states that the 18 suffixes beginning with tip and ending with mind replace the law after a verbal root. All these 18 suffixes are denoted by the pratyahara tin. The sutra Lah Parasmay Padam 1499 states that the first 9 affixes of the pratyahara tin and also suffixes satri and kwasu are called parasmay pada. These 9 suffixes are tiptas ji, siptas tha, mip was must. The sutra tangan navatmane padam 1400 states that the 9 suffixes designated by the pratyahara tang and also sanach and kanach are called atmane pad suffixes. These are to atam jho, thas atam dham. Tanganam atmane padam 1400 states that the 9 suffixes designated by the pratyahara tang, also suffixes sanach and kanach, are called atmanepat suffixes. These 9 are to atam jho, thas atam dham, id vahi mahi. It is relevant here to discuss the Paribhasa Sutra Sthanivadadeso Analvidho 1156. The Paribhasa states that a replacement for a substitute is treated like the substituent except with regard to an operation pertaining to phonological rules. So by the force of this rule, the thing suffixes will be equivalent to the particular lakara which it replaces in each case and undergo the change prescribed for the particular lakara or class of lakaras, that is lakaras which has indicated ta or na. The use of atmanaya pada and parasmaya pada suffixes in a given context will be conditioned by certain factors. Okay. Let us now describe the sutras which group the thing suffixes into persons and numbers. Tingas trini trini prathamam madhyamottamah 14101. This sutra groups the thing suffixes into 3 members. Prathama, third person, madhyama, second person, and uttama, first person. The same is applicable to tang suffixes. The sutra tanek vachana divachana bhavachana nek saha 14102 states that 3 and 3 triplets of the thing suffixes take one by one have the ekvachana singular, dvivachana dual and bahuvachana plural to denote them respectively. The terms ekvachana denotes one, dvivachana two and bahuvachana many, and they are represented by thing suffixes respectively as follows: person, third person, tip singular, tas dual, plural, ji. Second person, sip, thus, tha. First person, mip, was, mas. Third person, ta, atam, jha. Second person, thas, atam, dham. First person, it, vai, mahi. The sutra Bahusu Bahuvachanam 1421 defines the term Bahuvachana and states that the term Bahuvachana denotes plurality of the units functioning as subjects or objects. The sutra Dvekayor Dvachane Kavachane 1422 defines the term Dvachana and Ekavachana. The sutra states that terms Dvachana dual and Ekavachana singular respectively denote duality and singularity of the units functioning as subjects and objects. Let us now describe the sutras which define persons, namely third person, second person and first person. The sutra Yusmadipupade Samanadhikarane Sthaninyapi Madhyama 14105 defines the second person. The sutra states, second person triplets are used after a verbal root when the pronominal stem yusmad you co-occurs as a subordinate word either expressed or implied and denotes the same thing. For example, tvam pachasi, you singular are cooking. Yuvam pachatha, you dual are cooking. The sutra asmadyuttama 14107 defines the first person. The sutra states that first person triplets are used after a verbal root when the pronominal stem asmat, we, co-occurs as a complementary word either expressed or implied and denotes the same thing. For example, aham pachami, I am cooking. Avam pachavah, we two are cooking. Vayam pachamah, we are cooking. The sutra she prathamah 14108 defines the third person. The sutra states that third person triplets are used after a verbal root when a pronominal stem other than yusmat and asmat co occur as a complementary word either expressed or implied and denote the same thing. For example, sa tat pachati, he, she, it is cooking. Tau te pachata, they too are cooking. Te ta tani pachanti, they are cooking. Now in this module, we have discussed rules which are common to finite verb derivation. Sutras assigning thing suffixes, persons and numbers have been analyzed. The factors which determine the addition of atmanepada and parasthanepada suffixes to a verbal root have also been examined here. Students are advised to go through the 10th chapter of Panini Linguistics of P.S. Subramaniam, where these topics have been discussed in detail. In this module, we have tried to give the general rules defining the atmanepada, parasthanepada suffixes, and also defined here atmanepada, atmanepadi, parasthanepadi, and uvayapadi dhatus. Thank you.